Welcome, welcome, welcome. I am Crispy, and I sense it's time for some alien hominid invasion tips and tricks for ya. At the start of each run, you have the opportunity to spend any motherboard sticks that you may have acquired by either leveling up or by finding on the actual game board. When you insert them, you see you get instant unlockables. This is a way to become overpowered very quickly in the game, as it's random for each character what you get, but I only had to insert a few of those motherboard sticks to get a minigun, which is a very OP starting weapon. Next here we have the loadout screen. In the loadout screen you have the options for your weapons, which will give you a preview on top and a breakdown on bottom on the current equipped weapon and the stats on the weapon that you're looking at. There are different tiers of weapons, and as of this far I've seen gray, green, light blue, blue, and purple. I'm willing to bet there's a tier 2 or 3 above purple. When starting out the game, you only have access to one boost slot, so you have to choose wisely, but you unlock boost slot 2 as the game progresses. You also can customize your pigment, your head, and your mutation. Your mutation is something that you unlock as you beat headquarters. Going onto this page, this is like a mini built-in battle pass in the game. As you complete and progress through the game, you will level up, you get bonus rewards, and look at that, we just unlocked a whole page. The whole page unlocks a whole set of bonus cosmetics for you. It's completely random what you'll get, but you'll want to keep checking back to this page menu as often as possible to see if you've completed them. There's different levels of it, including just the pages, including enemies that you've discovered and killed, and including the heads and the pigment colors as well. Each one you can see, page completion reward at the bottom, what you're going to be getting as a reward. Some are cosmetics, some are money. Money is extremely useful in this game, as we'll see later when we get to the shop portion. At any point in time, in between levels, you can hit the loadout button, and then you can see what you've unlocked. Completing those pages unlocks some pretty powerful stuff, so you want to do it and check back as often as possible. That's how I got my first high-tier purple weapons, which are extremely devastating and helpful in the game, as well as some very useful perks in the boost category. Again, everything is RNG and random based, so you never know what you're gonna get. Your loadout and your unlocks could look completely different to mine, no matter what level we are, as you'll see in some of the multiplayer clips here with my other buddy. Let's talk about some stages here. Stages are random. As you click on the map, before you begin each one, you see it pops up with a hazard. You never know what the hazard's gonna be, but you wanna watch out for those. Each stage always starts with the exact same objective: kill the agents to get the intel. Collect the intel papers and insert it into the giant printer or fax machine or whatever this thing is. And once that objective is complete, something will pop on the screen to give you a next tier objective. This is always random as well. Sometimes you get lucky with something easy, sometimes you get like a mini boss type like this guy. The flybot hacker is kind of rough to stop, especially when you have all these hazards around, but once you defeat him, then it's right back to going to collect papers from the agents. Also, make sure you keep your eye out for the kid in the bushes. He sometimes will give you power-ups, he'll sometimes give you cosmetics. Cosmetics can also drop from random enemies at any point in time, so you never know where they're gonna be. You have to check the stage pretty diligently and keep your eyes open at all times for extra loot. Loot is awesome. There's generally about 3 to 4 phases in each stage. You can stick around for a bonus phase to try to get extra loot. I don't necessarily recommend it if you're trying to get through the stage, though. Every now and then, the sergeant will pop up here. and he will be very angry, so he'll send an actual boss at you. This is just a mini event. This generally will be the boss at the end headquarters, but you do not have to do that much damage, you just have to survive until the general calls him off. Once all that is complete, and you get the check mark, and you see the exit, that means it's time to get beamed up. So run to the exit as quickly as you can, and get out of there. You can stay, like I said, for a bonus objective, but it's not really necessary. Beating a stage gives you a score and a global rank, which is always pretty fun to see, as well as some level up rewards. Again, level up rewards are random for each person, as you can see right there. Also, at the end of each stage, you get a fun little grading to go over with your buddies. Let's talk about the bonus stage. Now, the bonus stage is a very fun stage that can randomly appear sometimes on your map. Whenever you see it, you want to try to get to it as quickly as possible. It's awesome. You only get one life in this stage, and your objective is to eliminate as many waves as possible. After each wave, you take these giant golden ice cream cones over to the partiers, and you get some loot and some gold. You continue until you die, and when you die, again, your run isn't over, but the bonus stage is over. And then whatever loot you have to frantically try to search for a hideout in order to secure it, because if you do not secure your loot, you lose it. It's very important to make sure, especially when you're carrying a lot of loot, that you find a hideout so that you can secure it. That way, even if you end up failing your entire run and not beating the headquarters, you didn't lose that much. These stages can be pretty brutal, and they seem to go up to at least 6 or 7 waves. Although, me and my buddies have never made it past wave 2, so good luck to you. Let's talk about the hideout! This is where you drop off the loot that you've collected, and look, you have secured it. So those are yours, unlocked instantly. Also in the hideout is the shop. The shop is a fantastic place where you can spend your gold that you've been earning through the stages, which again seems to be pretty easy to acquire, and the shop is extremely reasonable. You have a very random chance of getting some rare stuff, but you never know what's going to show up. And as you highlight over them, it will give you a comparison to what you have equipped and a opportunity to get better items. You can reset the shop as much as you want for as much gold as you have, and it's not going to deplete or change anything. In fact, the more times I reset it, sometimes, there you go, I saw a rare level 6 item. But you never know what you're going to get. Again, very RNG-based game, but I recommend collecting as much gold as you can, and then when you get to a hideout, just have a blast. The other thing that I noticed in the shop, which is really entertaining, besides going in here, editing your loadout, see this little button right here that says Show Stats? This gives you an in-depth breakdown menu of the stats, and you can really see how much these stats can increase. I mean, look, I'm level 39, and I haven't even increased my stats that massively. Look at how far lifesteal can go. Can you imagine maxing that bar out? When you lose, this is your final breakdown screen, giving you the total in-game session time as well as the total score for you and your buddies and a bunch of fun stats to look at. Overall, the game is great, totally worth the money. Just have to remember, make sure you buy it on the system that you and your buddies all have, because it is not crossplay. It is not crossplay. It's a budget title, guys. Sorry. Hope you enjoyed this quick tips and tricks video and you learned some stuff. Make sure you check back often for more content and live streams, and remember, always stay crispy.